Okay, hi, and welcome back. This is going to be part three, and we're really, really going to be talking about, in my opinion, a very, very critical piece of helping you recover from being floxed. And this is the cell membrane. So the whole third part is going to be on how can we restore your cell membrane health so that you can start to function and recover from being floxed. Okay, so let's get this going here. Okay, so part three, cell membrane health and what we need to do to restore it. So just to kind of give you an idea of what we're looking at. So this is the cell here. This is your cell. We're going to be talking about this layer right here, which is what I call the phospholipid layer is the top layer. And then we have the insides of the cell membrane. So there's really going to be two components. There's going to be really two components to this. There's going to be the outside layer, which we have to be focused on, and then there's going to be the inside layer of your cell. So we need to address both of these. Now, just to give you some understanding, is you're literally 100 trillion cells. You're literally a spirit in a cellular being. So when you've been floxed, your cell membranes are literally damaged. When your cell membranes are damaged, that causes the whole cell to malfunction. So one of the biggest keys to recovery is decrease your body's inflammation. So if you have a bad gut, you want to fix that. There's videos on that. So first thing is decrease your body's inflammation. Then let's restore and start to rehabilitate your cell membranes that have been damaged. All right, so this is pretty astonishing here. It takes 10,000 membranes to make the thickness of one single piece of paper. So 10,000 cell membranes to make the thickness of one piece of paper. So when you look at that, you have to really realize wow, dang, there's a lot of influence with your cell membranes that they're so abundant and so thick throughout your whole entire body. When we add those all up, we need to make sure that those are functioning well and optimally. So basically, this slide right here is going to go over the anatomy of what we're really talking about. So over here, you're going to see this is the cell membrane, okay? Now, what I want to be talking about here is there's really three things in here that I'm going to be talking about. I'm going to be talking about the EPA, DHA, and then what I'm going to be talking about is what I call the phospholipid therapy. So we're going to be doing basically phospholipid therapy is a combination of particular fish oils, EPA, DHA, and then phosphatidylcholine, which is going to be on the outside. So when I talk about phospholipid therapy, if you've heard me mention this in any other videos, it's just about the cell membrane. That's really what we're going to be focused on here. So what I want you to bring your attention to is, so we have the cell membrane here. And then look at this EPA. You see this blue thing right here. You see the EPA, which comes from fish oil, sits between these little membranes. So we have EPA and DHA. So this little line right here, this is the DHA. So all this right here, this is going to be the DHA. So now if you're taking fish oils, you're taking DHA and EPA. They come together. Right now, when we talk about your body, the EPA and the DHA, they do completely separate things in your body. And generally speaking, what I've seen, people that have been floxed, they have a lot of neurological problems, brain problems, neuropathy. So when we talk about that, we want to focus more on the DHA component because that is the component that's more heavily based in your brain and central nervous system. And then on the outside over here, what we have is the phosphatidylcholine, so you can see the phosphatidylcholine, which is this red thing right here. Then we have phosphatidylserine, which is that lime color there. Phosphatidylinositol, which is the dark green. So then there's different phospholipids that are on the outside of the cell. So we want to do phospholipid therapy to the outside and then specific nutrients on the inside. And really, really what I wanted to show you this is when we get into therapy, there's a two-prong approach. There's the EPA EPA and DHA, and then the second prong would be the outer phospholipid therapy membrane rehab. All right, so here, this is EPA and DHA. So when you look at the structure of these molecules, you can see how they're kind of like circular here. They're circular here. So what does this do to the cell membrane? So this right here would be the EPA or the fish oil in your cell membrane. You see how it's bent? This is causes fluidity in the cell. Now, if you don't have enough EPA and DHA or fish oil, there's no fluidity in the cell. So what happens in this point is this is your cell membrane right here. Now, if you don't have enough EPA and DHA, it becomes crusty. Now, when you start taking fish oil, the cell becomes fluid. When it becomes fluid, things can get in and outside of the cell. Now, as being flox, you need a floxy dose. You need a good, you need a let's get well dose, not like a maintenance dose or let's just be healthy. That's not the situation you're in. You need a floxy superdose. So this is really where it comes down to, is the dose really matters, how much you take. So the purpose of this slide is just so you can see what we're doing to the cells. We're making the cells more fluid. And then when you do that, you decrease inflammation. When you do that, you also allow things to go inside the cell and things to get outside the cell. Because what happens is if you have poor cell membrane health or poor phospholipid therapy status, I guess, your cell poops, okay? And that poop builds up in the cell. If that can't get out of the cell becomes toxic. It starts to affect your mitochondria even more, causing more damage, more problems because you can't produce ATP and you can't produce energy production. So this right here, this is an axon that we're talking about here. And what I like about this, as you can tell from my videos, I'm a real visual guy. So what we're kind of blowing up here is this part right here. This is what you're seeing over here. So this is the axon right in here, right? So this would be the copper wire, okay? So you have the copper wire. Then this swirl here, see how this swirls around? It swirls around here. That would be the insulation. That would be the insulation around the nerve. Now look at this right here. Now what I like about this is you see how this is wrapped around here? It's like a big sandwich. It's wrapped around. Now how this works, you see this line right? Let me just erase this here. You see this right here correlates to one of these phospholipid membranes. So when you talk about your neurons, this is wrapped around each other here. It's wrapped around, and each one of these is a phospholipid membrane that needs to be functioning. So when we look at your cells, right, your axons, your brain is full of axons, right? That's pretty much all it is. It's wrapped around of these phospholipid therapies. So you can see when you've been floxed, the phlox loves fatty tissue. It loves brain tissue. It just gets in there and penetrates it and messes up the mitochondria, messes up the neuronal function. So we really need to focus on restoring your phospholipid therapy membrane. Now, I'm getting pretty excited about this. Why? Because if you're out there and you're watching this video and you've been floxed, man, I guarantee you, like, there's no information out there that explains this. This is what it takes for you to get better, and I'm glad that you're in this course. So we really want to focus on that to really help that cell membrane increase its function. Now, here's Nordic Naturals. This is in a liquid form. Now, why do I like liquid? One, because it's cheaper. When you individually take fish oil and put them in capsules, that takes a lot of money. So it's more expensive. And when we talk about the volume that you need to take, liquid is the best to take. Now, this isn't like grandma's cod liver oil like back in the 70s. This stuff tastes good. This is good quality product here. So now this is Nordic Naturals. This is the link on Amazon, right? So you can go right to the Amazon and order this stuff right here. Now, this is the label. Now, you're going to see the fish oil here is, this is EPA and DHA. So natural occurring fish oil has these in them, EPA and DHA. Now, you can see how many milligrams this has of EPA of 745 and DHA of 500. Now, this is one teaspoon, okay? This is one teaspoon. Now, what happens if you've been floxed? You need 1 to 3 teaspoons. tablespoons per day. So let me just say that. 1 to 3 tablespoons per day is what you need. You don't want to take this all at once. You want to take this like you want to take this 3 times a day, like 1 tablespoon in the morning, 1 tablespoon in the afternoon, and 1 tablespoon at night. Now, if you start to get like loose stools and diarrhea, that kind of thing, it tells you that you're probably taking too much fish oil and too much fat. So when you take these supplements, you want to take these like 3 times the day. But you can see the dose is significant. We're not talking one little teaspoon here, right? We're not talking one little teaspoon. We're talking 1 to 3 tablespoons. So there's 3 teaspoons in 1 tablespoon, just to give you a reference point of what's happening here. So this is a really good dose of omega-3 fish oils, Nordic Naturals. They're clean. They're not farmed fish. So this is a really good product. So I want you to pay attention to the EPA and DHA ratio. Now, this is critical. This is critical for Floxies. Now, when we talk about EPA, DHA, the EPA, right, portion of the fish oil, that's used more for anti-inflammatory and cell membranes in your extremities, in your arms and legs, and in your organs. Now, DHA is highly concentrated in your nervous system tissue. Okay, so let me just go back to this here. So EPA is more for your like organs, extremities, and muscles. DHA here, this is more for brain tissue and nervous system tissue. So what does this mean here? So I like this. DHA's role in the brain and eyes. So if you look at the structure, more than 50% of the fatty acids in the cell membranes are DHA. Now, we're talking about in the brain and eyes here, okay? In the brain and eyes. DHA is particularly concentrated in the nervous system terminals where chemical signals between cells are exchanged. So, clinically, I've seen hundreds of Floxies now. They get anxiety, they get neuropathy, they get weird floaters in their eyes, right? Because this medication, the fluoroquinolones, man, they just love that brain tissue. They love the nervous system tissue. It goes in there and causes damage to that. So simply, you should just take the Nordic Naturals liquid. Then if you have additional problems, then what we need to do is we need to supplement with DHA strictly, and that's what I'm going to be covering here next. Okay, let me finish this up. So DHA for vital neurons. So DHA supports development and maintenance of synapses, which is neuronal synapses. 30 to 50% of DHA in healthy retinas. Okay, now it helps cell membrane, better neurotransmission here. Helps with cellular exchange within the cell tissue. Levels help support dopamine, serotonin, epinephrine, noradrenaline as well. Okay, essential to vision. Okay, get this. DHEA deficiency can reduce retinal signaling by more than 1,000 times. So DHEA is critical. Now, you can just take this product right here. This right here, it's on Amazon. There's the link. So this has I didn't take a copy of the back, but this has 500 milligrams of DHEA strictly. Let me see if I took a copy of this. No, I did not. Okay, so this has 500 milligrams. So in other words, you could take the Nordic Naturals plus you could take 2 capsules of this, which is strictly this DHEA in here.